Cancer, it's me, Stormy, and here is your yearly horoscope for 2020, and we are moving straight and full steam ahead into our brand new decade. But what I can tell you seems consistent for you, Cancer, is there still will be some work for you continuing on in the arena of relationships. So I don't think it's any great surprise, but we will be finishing up that Cancer Capricorn, so you versus the relationship aspects and access this particular year, and then you'll move on to doing some eighth house work, but not before we do some more work on relationships. 2020 is a big year. We've got Saturn and Pluto coming together at the beginning of the year. We've got three different Jupiter-Pluto connections that are going to be your helpers for the year. So I'm going to make sure you really pay attention to those dates. As well, we've got Jupiter and Saturn coming together in the energy of Aquarius, and this gives us the indicator that we're moving truly into some different waters. We have also got six eclipses happening this month instead of our regular four, and every planet that we have that can retrograde will retrograde. So it is quite the year, but I also think it's a year where if you remember that you have steady, sturdy endurance that you have developed, you can actually wrap up some situations this year that leave you space to have some brilliant new ones beginning, but it will take a lot of patience. So just put your patience hats on and let's jump into what's happening for you by date. Now, first and foremost, Mercury will retrograde three different times this year. It's going to be February, June, and October, and I will cover those in the smaller videos as well as giving you a breakdown of the Mercury retrograde itself. But what you can do is look back in my 2019 videos to the Mercury retrograde in your element video, and that'll give you a lot of explanation since the retrogrades are, again, happening in the energies of water. So make sure you hop on over and check that out, okay? First things first, Cancer, as we come immediately into 2020, we're starting with a lunar eclipse that's happening of 20 degrees of Cancer. So right here in your sign, in this first house space for you, and because this lunar eclipse is putting so much light, lifting the veil and showing you things about you, maybe your participation in relationships, I even think this year, Cancer, because we're starting the year with Jupiter in Capricorn, which is relationships, and then when Mars takes its retrograde, it's going to be towards the top of your chart. I really even think you are rethinking some career connections or some people in your life connections at this lunar eclipse. And it's going to give you the opportunity to end something, to acknowledge something, or to make the adjustments to you that you need to. Because another big theme that we'll see as we move towards the second half of the year is you standing up, standing on your own two feet. And that is not to say that Cancers are lazy or anything like that. So before I get the hate down in the comments, that is not what we mean. But where in your life are you needing to have more of your own independence, especially around your connection to relationships or what people think of you? This will be a great energy to shift you for the next 6 months and get ready to put you out there in a more firm and focused way that I think is what you want. January 12th, we've got Saturn and Pluto coming together in their conjunction at 22 degrees of Capricorn. Now, this is going to light up just across the street that seventh house energy. And this particular conjunction can be intense. And it is right on the heels of this lunar eclipse. So I do want to tell you, this could be a lunar eclipse time. This could be a few weeks that feel intense. They feel a little bit emotional because sometimes when Saturn and Pluto come together, they are a slow evolutionary energy. They bring in some loss. And as soon as the loss happens, they level you up and bring in something that is a better fit and better suited to you. It is really about transitions, and sometimes they come through a perceived hardship or something like that. That's why I tell you, in the area of your arena of your relationships, any place where you maybe have a contract signed with another human being, whether that be marriage or work or business partnership, any place that you have conscious chosen relationships, be prepared to have an evolution in that particular area, but also being a water energy as well, this just could hit you very intensely. Now, I do want to say this too. Just because you've got all this work going on in relationships doesn't mean everybody's going to blow out of your life. Maybe your relationships and your connections just need adjusting. 2020 is a year of endurance. If you and your relationships can make it through 2020, you might just be really, really good, but you have to look at what's the strength of this relationship, and everybody has to show up quite honestly, okay? When we get to March, Saturn is going to take this jump into the energy of Aquarius. Please, Saturn's not jumping anyways. He's scooting over, okay? Saturn is not jumping anywhere. He is moving into the energy of Aquarius, which is going to light up your eighth house. This is this beginning of joint resources, intimacy, independence, especially financial independence, dramas, traumas ending, healing happens in this house as well. And anything that's been happening in partnerships happens here. So as Saturn rolls in here, you might find yourself taking on more responsibility. It can feel heavier. But remember, Saturn is blowing in here to build new structures and level you up. And the structures he built will be sturdy enough for you to stand on for the next 29 years. So Saturn coming in here at this time, March 22nd, is going to give you a little sneak peek of what's to come as he permanently comes into the Aquarian energy at the end of this year until 2023. This is just a visit, but it will give you a sneak peek of what you'll be working on energetically as we move forward, especially into 2021. Now, we have got these three connections of Jupiter and Pluto. They'll be in conjunction with each other April 4th, June 20th and November 12th, and we are here for this, Cancer. This is brilliant, beautiful energy. It's like a surge of opportunity to growth. It's focused energy. It's intense. This is still an energy as well where if there has been loss, we've talked a little bit about loss already in this video. If there has been loss or challenge or hardship, you can actually recover from that. This can bring the opportunity here into your world to make something out of it, right? Make lemonade out of your lemons. This is just such a focused, brilliant energy, and it'll be happening in your relationship houses. So if you do need to make any changes, just first of all, know in this energy, you have support. There are people to support you. Jupiter is here. It is an expansive kind of energy, and it is likely a wise decision that you are making. And with Pluto being here, it's just this opportunity to put this wisdom and this rebirth into action. It's so focused. So please make note of those dates and use them very, very well to take a nice jump forward. May 13th through June 25th, we're going to see Venus retrograde in the energy of Gemini. Now, this is going to light up your 12th house space. Everything hidden or things that are naturally veiled or things that we keep secret, things we don't even know are back there, right? So you're going to have Venus in retrograde, which first of all, when Venus is retrograde, we do suggest that you not start any new relationships or make big investments if you can't avoid it, because after Venus comes out of retrograde, it's just not what you thought it was all the time. But things you can do with a Venus retrograde, especially there in the 12th house, especially with Gemini as the friend. Gemini is going to help you communicate well, right? In the 12th house, maybe you need to redo a financial investment. You've got so much going on in other relationships. Maybe there are some connections to a romantic partnership or something like that that need some healing, need some attention, need you to look back over them in some way, shape, or form. Another thought that I have for you, Cancer, especially because the 6th and 12th house axes are going to continue to be lit up for you as we travel through the year, is that maybe you've spent so much energy focusing on getting needs met or focusing on romance or focusing on finance or focusing on something in that arena that you find out in the 12th house how tired you are. Maybe Venus shows you how exhausted you are with not having a nice balance of this in your life, because you know when you're in a little bit of chaos, it's in your mind. There's kind of an obsession or just a thinking or an exhaustion that's a little bit low level that shows up over here. So this could be an energy as well where you're having an awakening with Venus retrograde here, where you realize you need to release this stuff, and it's okay to release this stuff so that you can restore your balance and your beauty, which is what Venus is all about as well. The last thing I'll say is truly, if there are any financial projects you need to wrap up, use this Venetian energy to go ahead and get those things solid, done, and clean out of your 12th house closet, okay? June 5th, we've got a lunar eclipse happening in the energy of Sagittarius. So see, this is my deal. We've got that Venus retrograde happening, and then just right behind it, we light up the 6th house, which is the house of health. wellness, daily routines. And I really think something that's maybe been on your mind or it's been in your sphere, it's really been taking a lot of your energy, and we connect this to the retrograde happening in the 12th house, you may just be getting information about things you need to be healthy. Maybe you need a different meditative practice. Maybe you need a meditative practice at all, right? Anything that's been hidden, I do think that this lunar eclipse over here in the 6th house helps you to adjust and acknowledge or adjust so that you can get on track with a better daily routine. It could bring work into your life, and it's Sagittarian energy, so it could be work that includes teaching. It could be work that includes travel, or maybe you're closing out some level of traveling with work, and at this time you're like settled. I think of like the soldier or something like that. Maybe you're stateside. Whatever it is, there could certainly be an element of travel that comes to this table. On the 21st of June, we're going to have a solar eclipse in Cancer, 0 degrees right there in your sign. And then on the 5th of July, we're going to have a lunar eclipse in Capricorn. And these two will end the Cancer-Capricorn axis dance that we'll be doing for the rest of the year. So in that first house, again, we've got a solar eclipse happening there in your first house. So this is an indicator that there is a fresh start in relationships. If you've done the work to continue on your work from that 2019 into 2020 around these relationships, you've done some cleanup, some reevaluation, and if you have taken your daily routine, your thought process, and your health back because you're not so stressed out about other people, whether it be family, business, relationships, money, whatever, this gives you an opportunity for a fresh start for the next 6 months with brilliant relationships. And that lunar eclipse is going to help you sweep out the rest of the relationships that don't belong, but also find your right space and balance. And I do think for some of you, it could usher in a very significant relationship for you. And that could be significant in the form of, yes, a romantic connection, but also maybe someone blows into your life and they show you really how to do and how to live this next level of life. Wouldn't that just be beautiful? September 9th through November 13th, we're going to have Mars retrograde in the energy of Aries. So Mars is very comfortable in Aries because it's a sign that he rules. So this is a pretty comfortable retrograde. For you, it's at the tip top of the chart up there. So this is why I say Mars is action. It's assertion, it's aggression, it's the way we're doing things and getting them done, but it's also our desires. So somehow, some way, in your career with this Mars retrograde, maybe you're going back over something, maybe you're redoing something, maybe your desires around the work that you're doing have changed, and so you're starting to take action differently around these things. During a Mars retrograde, we suggest that if you can avoid it, you don't do any surgeries or anything like that, because Mars does rule over the energy of wars and cutting and things like that, and your surgeon and your surgery itself would fall under that as well. But of course, life on life terms, my friends, so if you've got to have surgery, you have your surgery. All my prayers will be with you, and it's all good. Now, as we continue on and we get ready to end and get into the last couple months of this year, November 30th, we've got a lunar eclipse happening in Gemini. Boom. This one's at 8 degrees, so we light up that 12th house space again. You're going to start to become aware of some patterns, some beliefs, some behaviors that are not serving you. You might even start to continue working on something behind the scenes, or actually just begin working on something behind the scenes. And on the 14th, we've got a solar eclipse happening in Sagittarius. So the 6th and 12th house axes become lit up. What is in my secret stash that's affecting my everyday life? What's happening in my everyday life and I'm suppressing, repressing secrets, or I'm not spiritually as awake as I would like to be? What's hidden, right? So these two eclipses are going to begin your thinking and your action and your motion in those areas. Now, December 17th, we've got Saturn coming back into Aquarius for a few years until 2023, lighting up your eighth house. So you'll start to take responsibility for some independence, your own healing, connections to your partnerships. You know, if you're in partnerships, this could be a chance where they start to make more money, or they have some challenges either way that come up for them. But it is about leveling this area of your life up. On the 20th, we've got Jupiter stepping into Aquarius, now going to bring some expansion. And on the 21st, Jupiter and Saturn come together in the energy of Aquarius. Now, this is called the Great Conjunction. And when Saturn and Jupiter come together, They are called the rulers of the age. And as we move towards the age of Aquarius, we see the way these guys are going to shape our politics, our religion, our economy, law and order, wisdom, the way we teach, the way we learn. So it's going to be a very big kind of energy that brings a little bit of calm to all the chaos I believe we've been experiencing, but it will ultimately do it in the style of Aquarius, which is we need to do this different. We need a more communal sense in some way, shape, or form. So as we bring this down to the personal level of your life, this is a turning point for you. This is a turning point for you. Attitudes, actions, behaviors that you've had since 2012. Think back, 2012 to 2015. What was the hint of things that were changing for you, in your world, right? This is the energy now that is the turning point where you can take action to move those things forward. You get to move forward towards a future that you want. It's a lot more independent. It's healthy. It's successful. It is an energy Cancer that I think as the time we close this year out and get ready to really live 2021, you feel like, heck yeah, Cancer, hear me roar. So I'm very excited to see that, whether it be in business or it be in your personal life. There's just a leveling up available to you this year that I think is gorgeous. Okay, you guys, feel like I've talked so much, but I hope I gave you good details and an overview of what's coming for you in 2020. Now, if you want more details, you want more aspects, and you want them right now, you can always head over to my blog at stormygrace.com, where I've got the major aspects and the major transitions that are happening in 2020, and I've got them broken down month by month, so you can feel free to check that out over there. And of course, a general reading is always brilliant and beautiful, but if you want something more specific based on your chart, I would love for you to reach out. Let's do a reading. Let's connect in some way, shape, or form, okay? All right, you guys, like this video, comment, share, subscribe. I love you, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.